So this is Dhananjay. So I want to give a small practical session in PHP with the basic examples. Let us see what are the contents I want to discuss now. First one, how to run WAMP server after installing. And second one, how to write and save PHP code. And third one, how to execute PHP code. So I'll take one example like hello world example, and another one I'll take addition example. So by using these two examples I will execute the PHP code. And fourth one, how to integrate PHP code in HTML page. So fifth one, form usage with PHP. And sixth one, form methods using PHP example. Form methods means you can have like a post method and get method, right? By using two methods, how can you execute PHP? So let's start first one, how to run WAMP server after installing. So we already installed this as a WAMP server annadi. So mari ela run cheyali, so adi manam chuddam okasari. First step, click start button. So now next, type WAMP server in search box and you will get a start WAMP server icon on list box. Click on it and it displays one dialog box which it has yes, no, so which can give you like permissions like that. Click on yes, and finally on a taskbar tray on right side find green color icon. So green color icon anedi untadu akkada taskbar tray lo. So once the green color icon undi ante server anedi run avutundi ani artham. So then open web browser, either you can use Google Chrome or you can use Internet Explorer or Mozilla Firefox, and then type localhost http://localhost in an address bar and press enter. Then it displays your PHP output. Okay, PHP output in the sense related extensions and tools and everything. Okay, this is how you have to run a WAMP server after installing. Okay, this is the first step. So after two slides I'll explain in a practical way how to run WAMP server. Okay, next one, how to write and save PHP code. Let's see, first one, click on start, type notepad or choose any text editor. Then you will get a list of menus. From there find a notepad, then press enter. So then type PHP code, either you can use hello world example or addition example. Then save it with the file name called hello.php. So there ends second one. Let's see third one, how to execute a PHP code with a hello world example like addition example. Open browser, either you can use Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, and then check whether WAMP server is running or not. So by checking http://localhost, if it is running then type http://localhost/hello.php and hit enter. So after hitting enter, then definitely you will get an output like hello world. How to integrate PHP code in HTML page. So first you have to write HTML code. So HTML page will have a head section and body section. Head section contains a normal title. Then a body section, you can use a PHP code there. You can integrate HTML tags also. With that you can insert PHP code also. So less than symbol question mark PHP echo hello world question mark greater than symbol. So which it is a PHP code, so you can insert PHP code in HTML page. Fifth step, that is form usage with PHP. So here you have to create two pages, one is for HTML and another one is for PHP. So there in HTML, I taken as front add.html. So in that form method equal to post I use now, for action equal to add.php. So in action you have to specify PHP server side program, then only if you click submit button through the post method the action will be taken. Now in add.php I written addition program. You'll see in a live example. So let's start our live example. So first one, how to create, right? How to create, how to run WAMP server. So click start button, click all programs and type WAMP server. Or you can directly type WAMP, press enter, it automatically gives one dialog box. You have to click yes and then check in a taskbar tray, it is there green color icon, and then open Google Chrome and type http://localhost, press enter. So you'll get server configuration, PHP version and extensions and tools. Okay, so widget indicates WAMP server is running. So this is the first one. Okay, and second one, how to create PHP program. Now I am minimizing this. How to create PHP program, let's see. First click start button, type notepad and press enter, you'll get the notepad. Now type PHP code here. So this is PHP opening tag and I taken a comment displays hello world, and then I'm writing statement now by using echo. Echo is used to display content. I'm using hello world now and I'm closing my PHP tag. Now that's it. Now save this program with hello.php. hello.php. So for perfect saving you have to use double quotation front and back, and where you have to save. So please check C drive and choose WAMP and choose the folder called www, that is World Wide Web, that is a root directory, and then create a folder day one. Just I am taking an example, like I created one folder day one. So hello.php and then save. So find whether the file is there or not in a day one folder. Now open C drive. Now then WAMP folder, that is WAMP server related files, and again open www World Wide Web, and here today you have day one I created, right? Just now I created day one folder. Then fine, you can have like a PHP program hello. Now how to execute this PHP program, how to execute? So simple thing, open web browser, type localhost, and then so what is the folder you created earlier? What is the folder you created earlier? So day one, right? Day one slash, what is the file name you created? Hello.php. Hello.php. Press enter. So you got an output, right? This is how you have to create and execute PHP program. Okay, and check what is the difference between what is a normal hello.php and day one. So here whatever you place files in a www, either a folder or files, it can have, it is a root directory. So this is so whatever you are using, like www, world wide web, that is a public directory or root directory. Okay, in the directory we have to save each and every files or folder with files. So now localhost indicates, localhost indicates here www, and day one indicates a folder, and in that folder you can have like hello.php file, that is a type php files. Now if you want to create another file, then simply you can copy this, you can paste here, that is second file is created. Now you can use add.php, it automatically creates add.php, and you can execute there, no problem. But whatever the content you have that is not related to add, right? Now open with notepad and change the content. Like you can have like a dollar a equal to 10, next dollar b equal to 20, dollar c equal to dollar a plus dollar b semicolon, and to check the c value echo space dollar c semicolon save. Now check the file. So hello, instead of hello.php type add.php and press enter. Now whatever you given the code, like a equal 10, b equal 20, c equal a plus b, echo dollar c to print the value 30, it automatically displays. Okay, now close this. Notepad, press enter. Now insert html. Now here head section, which it has, okay, title. So form post method, which it has title, is entered now. And here we have to start body section is entered. Now here insert form action equal to so form-handler.php. I'll take, I have to create two files, right? First one is a HTML page and another one is PHP page. So and post method, I have to insert post method now. Okay, here form. Now here name, you take name now. Input type equal to text, and insert name equal to name. Okay, insert break again, insert age, and insert a number. Okay, insert a number. So here insert age. So I inserted only type equal to text. Okay, take number. Now input type equal to submit, name equal to submit, value equal to submit. Okay, now here you have to end, right? Finally completed. Now click on save button. See what is the file name you want to give now. post.html in which folder day one I am saving. Okay, save. Now again take another notepad for creating form handler.php. You created one HTML page with post.html, and now you have to create form handler.php, okay, for action executing. Okay, now file new, now insert php with opening tag, and now what's the variable we are taking? Name. Now here you have to use post, okay, $_post name. You taken that as a variable in HTML format. Now age equal to $_post age double quotation post, and then use echo to print the value. Echo your name, your name is right. Yeah, you have to use like echo your name is dot, you have to call variable name. So $name, whatever you created the variable here, you have to call this one here, okay. Now $name dot and you are dot $age dot years old. Okay, now this is ended. Now file save. What is the file name? You have to give form handler dot php. This is php. Okay, now we have to give small. Okay, this is case sensitive. PHP is a case sensitive, so it takes another one. I'm going to give capital. Okay, save. Now execute the program. Once again, we have to check whether the files is there or not in a VAM www day one. And now, what is the file you created first? Post. Okay, this is HTML part. This is HTML part. And now, what you created now? Form handler. Form handler is a PHP program. Now check here, you'll get. So first, if you type name and age, then if you click submit button, after submitting, it will check the action in a form. For it will find form handler.php file is there or not in a server directory. If it is there, it goes for form handler.php. PHP interpreter will check line by line, that is name, post. So it is already given name as Dhanu like that, and age as 28. Okay, if I give 28, then the values, whatever the values will be there, that values will be stored here, and through echo the statement will be print your name is so and so and your age is so and so. Okay, so this is HTML part and this is PHP part. You have to create two pages. Now execute post.html. So again type post.html. Now you got an output like Dhanu 28. Click submit. You'll get name, your name is Dhanu and you are 28 years old in a form handler PHP. Previously you have post.html. Whenever if you are clicking submit button, it automatically goes to second one, that is action. Whatever you are giving a value in action, that will be sent here. Okay, this is called form handler. Thank you so much. If you like this video, please share this, and if you like, please like it, and if you want to give a comment, you can give comment. Thank you for watching.